So let me show you how to use Tradingview alerts to set alarms for your entries and exits. And I want to show you some examples based on the trades that I personally trade. So the software that I use to find the best stocks to trade is the PowerX Optimizer. And I run it every day, and PowerX Optimizer has actually end of day data, meaning that the night before, you know what to do for the next morning. So when I ran the scanner last night, I saw that we had quite a few stocks popping up here: Apple, BKU, CLX, CVET. And I want to show you at the example of Apple of how exactly I use TradingView to set alerts to enter and exit positions. So as you can see here, based on the PowerX Optimizer, we want to buy Apple here. If we look at Apple, we want to buy to open it at 119.21. Now, if you are trading stocks, you can just set a stop order in the market and say, as soon as it moves above 119.21, I want to buy it. However, when you're trading options, you need to wait until Apple moves above 119.21. So let me show you how I use alarms for entries, and then I want to show you how to use it for the exits. So in order to set an alarm on TradingView, it is actually super simple. You can either just right mouse click and say add alert, or you can click on this little alarm clock on top in the menu bar right here. I'm going to click on this. It brings up the alert. And now the easiest way to use it is that we want to say if Apple is crossing, and whatever our entry signal is here, according to PowerX Optimizer, 119.21, then actually give us an alarm. Now, I only need it once, meaning that as soon as it crosses it for the first time, I want to buy a call option. So again, if you would like to know more about PowerX Optimizer and how I use it, go to mytradingroutine.com. I'll have a detailed tutorial there of how I use it. But I just want to show you today how to use TradingView and the alarms. Now, I select only once the expiration time. I set the expiration to today at 15:30. Now, again, this is my time zone and it is military time. So this is 30 minutes after the markets close. And here's why. For the entry, this entry signal is only valid for today. Tomorrow, we will get new entry signals. And in order to keep my alerts clean, I want to have them automatically expire as soon as today the markets close. So this is why I'm setting it to 30 minutes after the market close. Now you can set it to open-ended, and we'll talk about this in a moment when we talk about the profit target and the stop loss. Now here are all the alert actions. Now you can get notified on the app. I highly recommend if you're using alerts that you're downloading the TradingView app on your phone, because then as soon as an alert is being triggered, your phone buzzes. So important tip number one, set an expiration time. So that's the first tip, because by doing so, you will keep your alarms clean and not cluttered. Especially when you're on the free version of TradingView, you only have 10 alerts that you can set. So you want to make sure that you're not overusing them. So tip number two, use it on the app, because you probably have your phone within close reach. I mean, studies show that we have our phone usually within an arm's length for most of the day. So this is why this makes sense. You can also show a pop-up, and if you want, you can have a sound playing. I have a little handbell that makes a ding as soon as this goes off. And you can also send yourself an SMS. Now, I personally found the app more reliable than sending an SMS. An SMS is hit or miss, and depending on the traffic on their server, it might take a little bit longer. I have tested it, and I always got the alarm quicker in the app than I've gotten it through a text message. So I highly recommend that you do this. Now here, the important thing is actually the message. So for me, I like to put in the message what I'm supposed to do now, because this way, if your phone goes off and shows you the alert, you know exactly what to do. And here, if I want to trade options, I say as soon as Apple is crossing above 119.21, I want to buy the call option. So you could actually specify which option exactly you want to buy. Now, for me personally, I have PowerX Optimizer open, at any given time throughout the day. So it's easy for me to switch over. So therefore, all I want to know is if Apple is crossing above 119.21, I'm buying the call option. So this is the third important tip, and I'll show you how to do this for exits here as well. As soon as we do this, you see the alarm is becoming active on the chart. You see it right here, and you can also see it under alarms. If on the right-hand side, you click on alerts, you see that right now, Apple crossing above 119.21. This is where you will see the alert that says buy the call option. So this is how I use alerts for entries. Now, once you are in the trade, this is where I like to use it for exits as well. So if I bought an option right here, I need to sell it when the stock hits the stop loss and when the stock hits the profit target. Now, fortunately, PowerX Optimizer tells me exactly when to exit with the profit and also when to exit with a loss. So as you can see here, the profit target on PowerX Optimizer for Apple is 152.23. So I'm setting an alert for this, and all I do is I add an alert here, or you can click on the menu icon, the alarm icon here, doesn't really matter. And now I'm entering this value of 152.23 that PowerX Optimizer says. Now here I select open-ended. Okay, it expires after 2 months. That is fine on my plan. Okay, I thought that I could open-end it. I tested it earlier. It doesn't work now, no worries. Okay, so let's just set it to expire in a month from now. And if it goes above 152.23, this is when I achieved my profit target. And again, I'm giving myself very specific instructions of what to do there. So now I want to sell my call option that I bought when entering the trade. Super easy here. And as you will see, another expert tip for you, I'm copying this part of the alert because I'm kind of lazy and I don't like to type too much. So I also want to place an alert for my stop loss. And as you can see, my stop loss, as suggested by PowerX Optimizer, is 108.89. So I'm setting a new alert, clicking on this button, 108.89. And again, I'm setting it to a month from now. And as soon as this crosses it, see, now I have hit my stop loss and I'm selling my call option. See, for me personally, the more I write here in this message, the easier it makes it for me when it is actually time for this alert, when the alert rings. And you see right now, I see visually on the chart very clearly, my profit target is here, my stop loss is here. Now, if you want, you could also set alerts for the conservative target, no problem at all. You can have, however, this is where you're limited. In the free version, you only have 10 alerts. Now, if you want to upgrade to one of the higher versions, they're really not that expensive. I believe it is $15 per month. Simply go to rockwelltrading.com/tradingview and let me show you what you get with these other versions. So as you can see right now, I'm on an annual plan. So it is showing me all the prices annually. You can pay monthly. It is not a big problem at all. So as you can see here, for the pro version, you have 10 server-side alerts. The version that I am personally on has 30 server-side alerts. So you want to make sure that you have the right version for your needs. As you can see right now, just for one stock, I used actually 3 alerts, although technically I just needed one because I just need the alert for the entry. Once I am in the stock, I need an alert for the 2 exits. So I recommend that you never have more than 5 positions on at any given time. So this means that you would have 5 times a profit target and 5 times a stop loss. So 10 alerts. Therefore, as you can see, the pro version, which is probably priced at around $14, $15 per month, will do the trick for you. Anyhow, so this was a brief tutorial of how to use alerts on TradingView, how I personally use them with some expert tips so that you know exactly what to do. And if this was helpful, do me a favor and click on like right now, because this way I know that you're enjoying videos like this and I will do more videos like this. And also, if you like other videos or would like to get a notification whenever I go live, click on the subscribe button, hit the little notification bell. This way you get notified whenever I release a new video. Also, feel free to share this video on Facebook, Twitter, or by email. And I will see you in the next video.